So hello everyone, my name is Prakhar Agarwal. Today we will be discussing the chassis subdivision in a car. So we learn about the types of chassis, the material specifications, different parts of chassis, how to design and manufacture our chassis, and also we will be looking into the analysis part of it. Okay, so moving ahead, what is chassis? So chassis is the fabricated structural assembly that supports all the functional vehicle systems and subsystems. Now there are quite a lot of subdivisions in a car, and so there has to be a frame-like structure that can support and hold all the things together. So chassis does this work. It is basically the skeleton system that supports our car. Coming to the types of chassis, the first one is the ladder frame chassis. It is one of the oldest chassis, and it gets its name from the shape of ladder. It has two long and heavy beams which are supported by the short beams. The main selling point of the ladder chassis was how easy it was to manufacture. Okay, so during the beginning of the era of the automobile, technology was not really advanced, right? And so the simplicity of the ladder chassis made it easier to mass produce. The next type of chassis is the backbone chassis. It also gets its name from its construction, and it's present in the cars like the Skoda Rapid. One of the advantages of this type of chassis is that the cylindrical tube actually covers your drive shaft, okay, thus protecting it. The third type of chassis is the monocoque chassis, which means a unibody structure. And this is the most commonly used chassis right now due to the number of advantages it has. For example, it's safer. For example, it's safer than both the other chassis due to its cage-like structure. So it can be easily repaired, and it has superior torsional rigidity. The last one is the tubular or the space frame chassis, and this is the one that is of our use. So tubular chassis is mainly used in race cars due to the unrivaled safety they provide. And basically these were an upgrade from the ladder chassis, as they were three-dimensional and were stronger than the ladder chassis. So it has a lot of advantages. It provides better rigidity compared to other chassis of the same weight. And it offers the best weight to rigidity ratio, allowing the car to be lightweight while being strong. Also, these are complex structures, right? And so they cannot be made using the autonomous methods, and that is why they are time consuming to build. Okay, so moving ahead, coming to the materials used for making chassis. See, there is no specific material that is used for every chassis, right? So it depends on the requirements as well as the cost of the material. Most of the manufacturers prefer featured materials which are lightweight, economic, safe, and that can be easily produced. So steel stands as the first choice of manufacturers, as it has a wide variety of characteristics. The improvement and development in the steel industry made the steel stronger, lightweight, and stiffer than earlier. And the best reason for using steel as a body structure is because of its natural capability to absorb the impact energy produced in a crash, right? So the next material is aluminium, and the use of aluminium can possibly decrease the weight of the vehicle. Why? Because it has low density. So its low weight and high specific energy absorption are the key factors. And although aluminium is resistant to corrosion because of its oxide layer, yet it cannot always substitute for the steel parts. Why? Because of its low modulus of flexibility. Magnesium is another lightweight metal that is growing increasingly next to the aluminium in the automotive industry. It is 33% lighter than aluminium and 75% lighter than the steel elements. And since it has a low mechanical strength, therefore pure magnesium cannot be used, and so it has to be alloyed with other elements. So one advantage of using magnesium is that it has a high damping capacity, meaning that it can absorb vibrations efficiently. Apart from this, there is one more material that can be used. It is the carbon fiber. So if you see, दिस इज द RB15 रेसिंग कार, दिस वन. ओके, सो दिस इज द RB15 रेसिंग कार एंड इट हैज अ कार्बन फाइबर चेसी. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ चेसी आर द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट एंड सो दे आर क्वाइट एक्सपेंसिव टू मैन्युफैक्चर. या सो पॉइंट्स टू कीप इन माइंड बिफोर डिजाइनिंग योर चेसी, द चेसी शुड बी लाइट वेट. सो ऑब्वियसली यू डू नॉट विश टू अननेसेसरली इंक्रीज द वेट ऑफ योर चेसी, राइट. सो वॉट वी डू इज वी यूज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ जनरेटिव डिजाइन. इन जनरेटिव डिजाइन वी रिमूव द मटीरियल यूजिंग आइटरेशंस विदाउट एक्चुअली कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द कॉम्पोनेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लुक एट दिस इमेज. ओके, सो दिस वॉज आर ओरिजिनल कॉम्पोनेंट एंड देन वी यूज मल्टीपल इटरेशंस टू रिमूव द मटीरियल एंड दिस इज वॉट इट बिकम्स एट द एंड, दिस वन. ओके, सो नाउ देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन, इज यूजिंग अ लाइट वेट हाई कॉस्ट मटीरियल जस्टिफाइड फॉर योर फंक्शन? सी, ऑब्वियसली यू विल नॉट स्टार्ट टू यूज द कार्बन फाइबर फॉर योर FSC व्हीकल, राइट. सो यू नीड टू लुक एट द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कॉस्ट एंड ऑल्सो द रॉ मटीरियल फॉर इट. सो इन एडिशन टू दिस, द चेसी यू आर बिल्डिंग शुड बी सेफ, इट शुड बी एबल टू पास ऑल द टेस्ट. ओके, सो नाउ कमिंग टू द पार्ट्स ऑफ अ चेसी. द पार्ट्स ऑफ अ चेसी आर एज फॉलोज, द फर्स्ट वन बींग द फ्रंट बल्कहेड. सो इट इज बेसिकली द फ्रंट मोस्ट पार्ट ऑफ योर चेसी, दिस वन. सो इट इज बेसिकली द फ्रंट पार्ट ऑफ योर चेसी एंड इट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट एज इट विल एक्सपीरियंस द फर्स्ट इम्पैक्ट ड्यूरिंग अ क्रैश. ओके, देन वी हैव द फ्रंट बल्कहेड सपोर्ट. सो दीज आर बेसिकली द रॉड्स दैट विल सपोर्ट योर फ्रंट बल्कहेड, दीज. ओके, देन वी हैव द रोल हुप्स. सो बेसिकली देर आर टू रोल हुप्स, वन इज द फ्रंट हुप एंड द अदर बींग द मेन हुप. सो द फंक्शन ऑफ द रोल हुप्स इज टू प्रोटेक्ट द ड्राइवर इफ द कार रोल्स ओवर. सो दीज आर हेल्पफुल वेन द कार बेसिकली यू नो टर्न्स अपसाइड डाउन, देन दे आर यूज. एंड मोस्ट कॉम्पिटिशन्स आस्क यू टू कीप अ क्लियरेंस ऑफ से एटलीस्ट 50 mm फ्रॉम द ड्राइवर्स हेलमेट टू द लाइन ज्वाइनिंग द फ्रंट हुप एंड द मेन हुप. ओके, सो दैट इज इट. देन वी हैव द फ्रंट एंड द मेन हुप ब्रेसिंग, दीज सपोर्ट बोथ द रोल हुप्स नॉट अलाउइंग देम टू डिफॉर्म. द नेक्स्ट इज द इम्पैक्ट एटेन्यूएटर. सी, इम्पैक्ट एटेन्यूएटर इज नॉट एक्चुअली अ चेसी पार्ट बट येट इट प्लेज अ मेजर रोल, सो आई मेंशन इट. इट इज बेसिकली प्लेस्ड अहेड ऑफ द फ्रंट बल्कहेड. सी ओवर हियर, इट इज बेसिकली प्लेस्ड ओके इन फ्रंट ऑफ द बल्कहेड एंड इट्स रोल इज टू अब्सॉर्ब द एनर्जी इन केस ऑफ इम्पैक्ट. सो इट हैज अ फोम लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दैट अब्सॉर्ब्स एंड डिसिपेट्स द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द व्हीकल ड्यूरिंग अ क्रैश. द लास्ट वन इज द साइड इम्पैक्ट स्ट्रक्चर एंड एज द नेम सजेस्ट इट प्रोटेक्ट्स द ड्राइवर ड्यूरिंग अ साइड इम्पैक्ट क्रैश. ओके, सो बिफोर मूविंग अहेड आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. से दैट बोथ द कार्स ए एंड बी एज शोन इन द फिगर आर ट्रैवलिंग एट द सेम स्पीड एंड अज्यूम दे कोलाइड विद अ वॉल और से अनदर व्हीकल. ओके, सो इन विच कार विल द पैसेंजर बी मोर सेफ, कार ए और द कार बी? यू मे पॉज द वीडियो टू थिंक अबाउट इट. ओके, सो इफ यू चोज केस ए यू आर करेक्ट, द रीजन बींग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्रम्पल जोन. सो क्रम्पल जोन आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द क्रश जोन्स एंड दीज आर स्ट्रक्चरली सेफ्टी फीचर्स टू इंक्रीज द टाइम ऑफ इम्पैक्ट. दिस इज योर क्रम्पल जोन. ओके, सो इन कार ए द पैसेंजर विल फील लेस इम्पैक्ट एज कम्पेयर टू कार बी. वाई? बिकॉज द क्रम्पल जोन इन कार ए हैज ऑलरेडी अब्सॉर्ब्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द एनर्जी, वेयर एज इन केस बी द एनर्जी इज नॉट अब्सॉर्ब्ड एफिशिएंटली एंड दिस एनर्जी पासिस ऑन टू द रियर साइड ऑफ द व्हीकल कॉजिंग ह्यूज फोर्स टू बी फेल्ट बाय द पैसेंजर. ओके, एंड सो दिस वॉज द रीजन वाई मारुति ओमनी वॉज यू नो डिसकंटिन्यूड, बिकॉज ऑफ द सेफ्टी रेगुलेशंस एज इट डिड नॉट हैव अ क्रम्पल जोन. सो द नेक्स्ट डिस्कशन इज अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ट्रायंगुलेशन. ट्रायंगुलेशन इन्वॉल्व्स द यूज ऑफ ट्रायंगुलर शेप्स टू गिव स्टेबिलिटी टू स्ट्रक्चर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव अ ट्रायंगुलर शेप एंड अ स्क्वायर शेप. सो विच शेप शुड यू चूज फॉर मिनिमम डिफॉर्मेशन? See, well, if you apply the same force on both the shapes, it is clearly evident that the square will deform more, and it will most likely to take the shape of a rhombus. And so this is why your chassis structure should be, you know, highly triangulated. So for example, in this case, we placed one rod as the diagonal of the square, this one. So what happens is, now this square gets divided into two triangles. One triangle is this one and the other is this one. Okay. The same example is explained here in details. So without the diagonal, it will easily deform. While with the diagonal element, it will try to resist, thus preventing movement. Okay. So this is the reason why bridges are highly triangulated. Another example that follows this triangulation concept is the structure of the Eiffel Tower. Okay. So the loads acting on a chassis. Well, there are many loads acting on a chassis. First is the static load. So static load is basically the load due to other parts of the vehicle, okay, such as your engine, body of the car, transmission parts, etc. Inertia load is when your car is moving and the brakes are applied, okay. Then we have the impact load. So impact load is due to the collision, say with another vehicle or a wall. Short duration load is when you cross a broken patch of land. Okay. Momentary load is caused while turning or moving on a curved path. And overload, as the name suggests, is when the load is beyond the design capacity of your vehicle. Okay. So having discussed all this, now the question arises, from where should you start the designing process? Okay. So chassis design usually starts at the end. Other subdivisions need to first design their parts, and then according to them the chassis is designed. So what happens is that the suspension teams gives you four hard points. One, this one, second being this one, and similarly the third hard point and fourth hard point. Okay. And from these four points the design process begins. So coming to the last topic of this presentation, the analysis part. So you need to perform many tests for your chassis. These are as follows: the front impact analysis. So in this analysis, the loading point is the frontmost member of your chassis. The constraint will be the rear suspension hard points. The force is calculated by using the formula F equal to ma, and then the further analysis is done. I'll show you how the force is calculated. So we use the formula F equal to ma. The mass of our car is assumed to be 300 kgs. The initial velocity of collision is taken to be 60 kilometers. And after collision, the car will come to a halt. So the final velocity will be 0 kilometer per hour. Now acceleration is calculated by the formula dv over dt. Okay. And the time of impact is taken to be 0.2 seconds. So how do we get this time? So actually the time of collision has been calculated by the engineers by actually colliding the car with a wall, and from there reverse engineering is done. So this is how we get the time. And then if we calculate, we get force is equal to 300 into V2 minus V1, okay, divided by 0.2, and we'll also multiply by a factor of 5 by 18 because we need the force in newtons, right? So we need to multiply by 5 by 18, and this comes out to be 25,000 newtons. Okay. Similarly, we have to calculate the forces, the loading point and the constraint point for the rear impact analysis, side impact analysis and the rollover analysis. Torsional stiffness analysis is a bit different, and it is required when there is a biased lateral load on the vehicle, say during a turn. Okay, so a torsionally stiff chassis would perform better. Okay, moving to the next slide. Okay, so this is our final slide, the key points to keep in mind while doing analysis. So the method we use is the FEM method, which stands for finite element method. In this method, a large system is divided into smaller, simpler parts that are called finite elements. Okay, so this process is called meshing, and usually smaller mesh means more accurate results, but the computing time also increases significantly. Hence, a balance is to be made. So while analyzing the results, we should be careful that we are not seeing the actual deformation, and instead the deformation is scaled for visual enhancement. So apart from this, the important point is that the forces and the other parameters that you calculate, they should be accurate. Okay, so I will end with the phrase, an analysis is only as good as the analyst. So that was all from today's session. I hope you learned something new. Thank you.